Welcome to Pediatrics by Dr. Ann, and then I'm Dr. Pavitra. The answer to the bronchiolitis obliterans question is option B. Bronchiolitis obliterans syndrome is a histologic diagnosis. So to know the difference between these terms, let us see the explanation. So there are 3 to 4 terms in bronchiolitis obliterans. The first one is bronchiolitis obliterans, bronchiolitis obliterans syndrome, and bronchiolitis obliterans organizing pneumonia or cryptogenic organizing pneumonia. So both of them mean the same. So let us see bronchiolitis obliterans first. So bronchiolitis obliterans is basically a histologic diagnosis in a non-transplant patient. It is generally secondary to infection or inflammation of, note this, terminal respiratory bronchioles and alveolar ducts. This causes obliteration of the lumen, hence the term bronchiolitis obliterans. Okay, so there is abnormal repair secondary to epithelial damage. So let us see about bronchiolitis obliterans organizing pneumonia or cryptogenic organizing pneumonia. This is also a histologic diagnosis. So what is the difference between them? See, here apart from alveolar ducts, the alveoli are also involved. That means a parenchymal involvement by fibroblast proliferation. So pneumonia means parenchymal involvement. So alveoli are also involved. Alright, so both are histologic. The difference is in the areas of involvement. So what is this in-between term, bronchiolitis obliterans syndrome? This is a clinical diagnosis. This happens in post-transplant patient. Okay, so it's either post-bone marrow or post-lung transplant. So how do you diagnose all these three? The ventilation perfusion scan shows a moth-eaten appearance. Okay. HRCT shows a mosaic pattern. Which is the diagnosis of choice? Investigation of choice will be an open or transbronchial lung biopsy. Right? Thank you.